indoor show, guys. It's been a long time since we shot a show, right?
Oh, yeah.
Robbie?
No doubt.
Where are we today, bud?
Looks like a war zone of some sorts. Maybe Afghanistan?
Pluto, keep your head down, Private Walker. No, it's not Afghanistan.
Payson? Same thing.
Hey, take a look right over here, Bryce. Pan right over here.
Oh.
Come.
Oh. I think I know where we are.
Dana White poses.
Guess what?
What?
We're gonna bring our guest in right now. He is a soldier.
Really?
Way exciting. The real deal.
If we can get him to come right now, he's on the city council.
Oh, he won't come if he's on the city council.
We're not kissing up, are we?
Right here.
He's not. That's Councilman Scopes.
That is.
It is.
Didn't recognize him without his white shirt and tie.
Right. Hey, we want to welcome Keir Scopes to our new Goose in the Wild show today. And what do you think about this Army stuff?
I love it.
They have cool clothes.
How long we been doing it?
I've been in 16 years.
So he's the real deal.
Boy, I'd say.
So how much does that look like Afghanistan?
That looks a lot like Afghanistan. Afghanistan looks a lot like the whole Wasatch Range. In fact, my deployment to Afghanistan, our task force was called Task Force Wasatch.
Booyah!
Huh? Wow! Booyah, Jack! Does that sound like Uncle Si?
Not bad.
All right. Well, the first question I want to ask you is, and people's probably wondering it, why do we need the National Guard? Why do we need it?
Well, the National Guard was originally established really to, or the intent of the National Guard is to defend the nation. More specifically, each state. Each state has a National Guard, has different units, and our principal mission is to, for natural disaster, anything that the governor requires. Really, that's our commander-in-chief is the governor of the state of Utah. When we go off to Iraq and Afghanistan, where I've been to both those areas, it's been at the request of the president, where the president asks the governor to use the governor's soldiers. And so we belong to the state of Utah. And we do it just as well, if not better, than the active duty we feel.
That's what I'm talking about.
All right.
That's what I'm talking about.
Okay, we're going to go meet our next guest. That'd be Sergeant Nelson. Jim Nelson, not Shu, another Jim Nelson. Kirk, where's Rob?
I don't know.
These boys have all the fun toys.
That's not a toy, son.
Okay, baby. Okay, guys, we're inside the armory now.
Armory.
And we want to introduce you to our next guest. It's Sergeant Nielsen. I had it wrong. I said Nelson outside.
You did. I heard
it's it. It's Nielsen.
Oh, he probably doesn't care. He's probably a good-natured guy.
He doesn't look good-natured, Bryce.
We ought to take a look at him, man. Welcome to our show. Do I get a handshake?
Well, we don't normally shake hands.
Why is that?
You want a hug?
Salute.
Oh, we salute.
We salute. We stand at ease.
Oh.
And that was wrong. And your fatigues are wrong.
Those are fatigues?
What is fatigues?
Hey, this is the best I got, man.
Just come in just off the street, dressed like a dirt bag.
No, whoa. You can drop the hard
stuff. No, you can drop the hard stuff. What
Sorry.
Hard stuff?
This is the way he really is.
Let's pay attention.
So,
yes, sir.
Our viewers
hey,
want.
He said attention.
As a matter of fact, attention! That's a little better. It's more like it.
Second
now,
gut.
How come the only real soldier in line here is just chuckling?
This is our councilman, by the way.
You show me attention. Okay, see? I always wanted to say that to somebody. It's not like he outranks me by about 20 degrees.
Hey, this is a serious show with guns.
You know what this reminds me of, Rob?
Deacons?
No, worse than that.
What?
My PE class.
What?
Did you always talk to the position of attention at PE class in junior high?
No, sir.
Well, you can call me Sergeant.
Yes, sir. Sergeant, sir.
So what's it going to be, sir or sergeant?
I don't know.
Let's stick with sergeant.
Yes, sir. Sergeant.
Yeah. I've got a few names I can call you, but I'm more polite.
My wife isn't.
Well.
So what is your title down here?
I'm the readiness NCO for Charlie Battery, 145th Field Artillery.
Holy smoke. You speak Spanish, don't you, Brad Bryce?
Yeah, that sounds like
speak Spanish.
Brad Bryce?
Readiness NCO.
Do you
know what that
means?
I speak Spanish. What is readiness NCO?
Readiness NCO. NCO is non-commissioned officer.
NCO. NCO.
Non-commissioned officer.
Okay.
And readiness, his job is the readiness of the battery, making sure they have the schools, the training, pay allowances, all the things they need to be able to do their job.
What I'm thinking, out on the sign it says soldiers wanted. So what kind of a young man are you looking for? You mentioned recruiting.
We're looking for a young man that has a desire to serve his country, that can think for himself, that's motivated, that's physically fit, and has a desire to serve is what we're looking for.
Thanks. Appreciate that.
No kidding.
So one of his main objective is to get the money for college.
That is a benefit that they offer in the military. But I would say that should not be their first motivation. Their first motivation should be serving their country and their community and bettering themselves. And any monetary benefit that's going to come from that would probably have to be secondary.
Sergeant, may I ask a question?
You may.
What about the ladies?
There's positions for females in the military as well. Some of the units are combat arms, and the females, there's some positions that may not be open to them, but there's certainly areas and job skills that they can learn and can benefit them and in the military as well.
Are they still called the whack and the wave?
They're not. Those terms have expired with
with Goose.
In the 50s and the 60s.
Oh,
so
really?
We'll bring you up to speed on the proper terminology.
That's the 1850s and 60s for you.
Oh, okay. Okay, we're going to go to our next break, Bryce.
Okay.
And we're always telling our viewers to go get something nutritious to snack on while they're watching Goose in the Wild. What would you recommend?
Drink water.
Hydrate
water,
or die.
Keep hydrated. Drink water.
Especially it's in the mid-90s out there today.
That's right.
Okay. So go get you some water, and we'll be right back.
All right. What room are we in now, Sergeant?
So like I said, physical fitness is key. We're in the gym, the workout room here at the Armory. And we're where the soldiers come in, stay physically fit, do their best. And these two fine specimens are certainly doing something. I don't know if it's physical fitness, but they're actually trying their best.
All right.
Wow.
I actually see one that's actually doing push-ups, though.
Yeah, those are doing push-ups. I'd say those are to standard.
Okay. All right. Are you done? What'd you do, 10 already? Now, I got to ask, though, are these sit-ups to standard here?
No. No, not even close.
No. What's the deal with starting on an incline?
Yeah, you don't. The military tests on push-ups, sit-ups, and a two-mile run. A soldier that's coming into us brand new.
Make him pay his dues, though.
He's got to pay his dues. But as soon as he meets that minimum requirement, by the time he leaves basic training and AIT, he's going to be lean and fit and fully qualified. And he would be doing probably upwards of 60 to 70 sit-ups in 2 minutes.
Does that make you hurt?
Yeah, that was painful.
All right.
I cut you a little slack on your whatever this outfit is, your pajamas.
You think that's funny?
We don't wear hats indoors, and we certainly don't wear them backwards.
And why is that?
Well, it's disrespectful, for one. I know your mother taught you better.
Oh. You know, put the hat on and lower the visor and give us all a break.
That's a start.
Excuse me, Sergeant. I think he was giving you a glare. Perhaps some push-ups would be in order.
I'm used to glares. But I'm not fearing you any. So you can glare all you'd like.
What about that glare?
That's a little better.
Oh, stop.
That's a little bit.
What about that glare? All right, let's go to another area, baby.
Let's do it.
Oh, can I call you baby?
No.
We're taking baby steps. We'll have you train before you leave here. The drill hall, the drill floor, this is where the battery and companies would form up, have their daily formations.
Wow, this is a basketball court and everything.
Look at this, Sergeant.
Way cool.
That's the standard. That's the Army combat uniform.
Did you have to wear one of these?
I have. I've got several pair at home.
Well, what's your feelings on the uniform?
I love the uniform. I take great pride in wearing it. One thing a lot of people don't know is the uniform is very precise. Everything placed on the uniform, whether it's a patch, your rank, your name, medals, awards, is all measured and has a specific and exact location to an eighth of an inch. It's that level of detail we want our soldiers to take on their uniform. We want them to take that same level of attention and detail when they maintain their weapons, when they maintain their bodies, when they do their training. If they can follow this level of attention and detail on something simple like a uniform, they certainly can do it on a gun, on a weapon, on things that matter most to keep them and their buddy alive.
I'm just happy when I can get my kids to tie their shoes. So. That's
now,
a lot of instruction.
I noticed some detail on the goose man here. Like, that's pretty fluorescent there. Is that standard color for Army or National Guard?
That is not. That is not subdued. He does not blend in.
Are you ever
going to
stop giving him crap, do you think?
No.
You're going to keep giving him crap all day, probably.
Like I said, he's an easy target.
A fashion faux pas.
Not just an easy target, a big target.
Okay, so that wouldn't be good in Afghanistan.
No. No, certainly not. I can't think of any situation where that would be good.
Including on TV.
Aerobics.
That was very good. See, he could be funny, too.
Okay, all right.
All the trash you're talking about him.
All right. If you notice, Bryce.
Yeah.
We're in my domain that I spent 35 years in the gymnasium.
Yeah.
What goes on in here?
Well, this armory actually gets a lot of use from the community. There's a lot of basketball events that take place in here. There's some local schools that utilize this for practice. Like I said, we're a National Guard unit. We depend on our community for support, and in turn, we like to support the community.
Way cool.
Do the soldiers get to play hoops?
Not very often. We like to keep our training centered on helping that soldier fight, survive, and come home in a combat environment.
These guys are
way
cool.
There's not a lot of time for basketball.
So if a young kid is going to get into the Guard because he thinks he might be playing some hoops?
I would counsel that prospective enlistee to look elsewhere.
If a kid ain't into shooting, but he's more into the brainy things and runs the computer in the howitzer?
Our howitzers are ran by computers.
Wow.
They're told where to aim and where to position by computer. There is room for anybody.
We're going to get in a howitzer.
I don't think we want you anywhere near a
howitzer.
What's
the difference between a tank and a howitzer?
A howitzer is a long-range indirect fire weapon. And it's a lot better than a tank.
Yeah.
Sergeant, permission to speak freely.
Go ahead.
Please do not let him drive the howitzer tanky thing.
He will not be driving any howitzers, and they're not tanks, and they're not tanky thingies.
Okay. What about, can I?
He's not cutting you any slack.
So, which one would you want to be? Would you want to be the gunner?
I want to drive.
Who's the guy that does the shooting?
The gunner. All the cannoneers know how to use their howitzer. Use their weapon to its maximum effectiveness. We don't pull triggers, we pull lanyards.
Oh, lanyards.
Like that ropey thing?
I wore a lanyard teaching PE.
It's kind of weak.
Yeah. Enough's yakking. Yes. Let's get out in the yard.
Let's do it.
Here.
Yes.
This is not a tank.
No, this is not a tank. And I'll defer to Sergeant Nielsen. I'm an intel officer. My job is to find the enemy, to target the enemy, get that to the targeting, the AFATADs, and then they actually get it out to the cannoneers, to the guns, where they shoot the targets that I acquire. So Sergeant Nielsen would know much more about this equipment than I do.
So cool.
When we were walking over here, the thought came into my head.
Oh no, I'm already worried.
Oh no! Have you ever been shot at?
I have been shot at, yes.
And what's the feeling?
It's an unnerving feeling, but that's just part of the job, and you train so you know what to do, and you don't really think about it. It's second nature. You return fire, you get out of the way, whatever the job is, you take care of business.
And so, have you had to shoot at people?
No, I've been fortunate the positions I've been in where I haven't had to fire directly at a person.
And when that time comes, or if it did, would that be something you could do?
That'd be something I could do without hesitation.
Why is that?
Because it's much more important I go home to my family than they go home to theirs.
Wow.
That's good.
Wow.
This show is so cool.
Wow. Wow.
That's three wows.
I never thought of that.
I don't know if we've
a triple wow.
Yeah.
The Soviets, they had identified this years ago as one of the strengths that the U.S. Army has, or the U.S. military, is we don't fight for pay, or we don't fight for political agendas. We fight for our battle buddy. And so everything we do is to make sure that our battle buddy comes home. If Sergeant Nielsen and I were off in Afghanistan or Iraq together, everything I do would be to ensure his safety and to make sure that he goes home to his family. And I have every faith and confidence that everything he does would be to ensure that I go home safe to my family. And because of that strength and that brotherhood that we have, that makes us a much greater force than any force in the world.
Bryce just hangs us out to dry.
So does that hold true if you don't really care that much for your buddy?
I don't know a buddy yet that I don't care for.
Is that because you're putting your lives in each other's hands?
Very directly, yes. As an officer, the plans and the training that I establish, Sergeant Nielsen, if we were in the same unit, he would be carrying out. We would be working together to ensure that our soldiers have the best training, the best facilities, so that they have everything they need to be able to do their job, to execute it properly and well, and to return home safely.
Well said. Wow.
Let's see what this unit does to make sure the other guys don't return home safely.
Yeah.
This is a M109 Alpha 6. It's a medium self-propelled howitzer. It's a 155 millimeter projectile. It shoots. The artillery is, after all, the king of battle, and we take that seriously. Our mission is to suppress, neutralize, and destroy the enemy, and we prefer to destroy them, and in this vehicle, this weapon system, is more than capable of that.
So how far can this baby shoot a projectile?
The maximum range, the maximum capability on this weapon system is right around 30,000 meters.
And in layman's terms?
Yeah.
30 kilometers.
In layman's terms?
About 20 miles.
Yeah. Wow. So wow. From here to Lehigh?
From here to Lehigh.
Yeah.
So Bryce,
let's try it out.
I was thinking,
if you were at Saratoga Beach, suntanning,
yeah. We could reach out and say hello.
Wow, that is something else. 20 miles, Robbie boy.
Let's start him packing now. By the end of the show, you'll be in Lehigh. Radio us, and we'll try to acquire you as a target.
You could be a forward observer.
If he wasn't so good at intel, I might consider it. It was just Goose, but yeah.
Goose had hit pacing.
Yeah.
Especially with the radio. Make sure you key that mic and keep keying it. That'll help us find you.
We have no problems talking.
Now, do we get to go inside?
We can go inside and take
a
look.
Yes, yes, yes. Look at it. Just like a little kid.
I am.
A new
I'm
pair
so
of
happy.
Sneakers, man.
I'm so happy.
There's that age requirement.
Oh, man. Oh, yes. Yeah.
That's just up here.
Oh.
Oh, yeah.
Look at this.
Come to daddy.
Look at this. Bricer boy.
It's about time we did something cool on this show.
Hey, is this baby named Big Dog?
This baby hasn't been named yet.
Okay, let's name it Bryce Dog.
How's that? Yeah. I'm so happy.
I'll run that up the chain.
Bryce Dog.
They got one of them top hatches and stuff. So cool. Oh, look at this. Oh,
now, can you close him in and lock him in for me?
I can do that.
Are you coming in, Sarge?
We're actually going to close you in and leave you.
Hey, we don't want to do that. I got claustrophobia.
Okay, I think we should do it.
So if a guy had claustrophobia in the Army, would this be a good job for him?
This is so cool.
I would say the Army is really good at helping an individual overcome their fears.
They don't have time to be claustrophobic. There's an awful lot they're doing inside this gun.
Check out the barrel on this gun.
All right, I guess we better go in.
Oh, yeah.
Cover me. I'm going in.
And it's so cool.
Okay.
Look, there's what they do in the movies, like they open the thing. But
hey, this is where it's an advantage to be Rob's height.
Shut up.
Look at this, he's standing.
There was the Seven Dwarfs movie, too, you know.
That's why you don't see an awful lot of tall guys.
Look, it's one of them Dunport barrel things.
Actually, that's just the engine.
I was thinking, we watched Nick Wallenda walk across the Grand Canyon on that tightrope. Boy.
That surely has something to do with this.
What was that all about?
Hey, he was talking about overcoming her fears.
Oh, I knew we were going to get there.
You know that.
No, I didn't.
What do you think of that?
I didn't get to see him walk across the canyon. Oh. I heard a lot about it.
I don't even have TV, but is that where you put the bullets?
That is the ready rack.
Oh, yeah.
That is where the projectiles go.
Can we open this barrel so we can see how big they are?
We can.
Yeah.
This is where we load the round, the projectile, and put the powder behind it. This mechanism here is actually the trigger. The lanyard attaches here and essentially fires the weapon. I'll go ahead and open the breech.
I'm so happy. It's got such cool stuff.
I guess we'll just let Rob take over at this point.
I just want to play.
All right.
I have to. So we can get a look down there.
Oh, that's cool.
Oh, yeah.
Wow, that is a heavy monster, isn't it?
Can't get it to lock. There we go.
Oh my God. Hey, we can see right out that thing.
So it is just, you know, just like a rifle. It's got the riflings.
Oh, yes, sure does.
Bullet.
Wow, that's amazing.
I believe it's 13 and a half feet long.
Yes. I'm so happy.
That's really cool to see the riflings in there.
We'll close this up.
Help him out, Goose.
Hey,
like Goose, those
are I'm a newbie.
So the piece closes up. We prime it right here. You can see it's called the vent hole.
Okay.
Slide it over, hook up the lanyard, piece of rope to the trigger. The chief gives the command to fire. He pulls the lanyard with his waist, and the recoil, depending on the charge of powder we're shooting, it'll recoil all the way back, you know, up to 4.5 feet.
Wow.
Wow.
This show is so cool.
Wow.
'Cause freedom don't come free. I'm an American soldier, an American. Beside my brothers and my sisters, I will proudly take a stand. When liberty's in jeopardy, I will always do what's right. I'm out here on the front lines. Tonight, American soldier, I'm an American soldier.
We have four soldiers to a gun crew.
So what is the titles of the four men?
They are cannoneers.
Cannoneer.
There's cannoneers, there's the section chief, the gunner, and the assistant gunner.
Ooh.
And my sisters, I will proudly take a stand. When liberty's in jeopardy, I will always do what's right. I'm out here on the front line, so sleep in peace tonight. American soldier, an American.
you from the bottom of my heart. May God bless you, and may God continue to bless the United States of America.